I mean, you can't even buy soap without having some kind of sexual connotation in a commercial, right? I mean, everything is just so tainted. And, you know, recently, actually just last weekend, Tom Reese, the Pendel Honor Bound director, he did this topic workshop in the conference we had last weekend, and he had this stat, and I'm going to steal the stat, so I gave him credit, so it's not really stealing, but he said this stat, 95% of all teens are online, 78% of them own a smartphone, 93% of boys and 63% of girls view porn before the age of 18. Dads, you think, we all been taught you need to train your son, you need to help your son not fall in the trap. 63% of our daughters are falling in the trap of pornography. It's not just a man thing anymore. You gotta protect your daughters as well. At age 11 is the average age one first views porn. Age 11. In ages 12 to 17 is the largest consumer of porn that there is today. 12 to 17, that is who watches the most porn. And you know, those numbers, they pretty much ring true with my story. It's kind of around the same ages where I walked into that garage and I fell into the trap. And it's just, guys, we need to do better. I need to do better, we all need to do better. We need to be protecting our kids, we need to be protecting ourselves. And we need to take a stand. God calls us to be a light to the world. And the world, you know, they define a real man. What's a real man according to the world? Anybody? The world sees a real man as a guy who's with a different woman every night. You know, he's always dating, he doesn't want to settle down. And you see it on TV and movies, the playboys, the guys who are bringing home different women. That's what the world defines as a real man. That is the exact opposite of what God calls to be a real man. And we want to be godly men. We don't want to be men of the world. We want to be men of God. And you know, it's one of the biggest lies that Satan's using to destroy the lives of men in our culture. Did you know that 80% of Christian single men are sexually active? I'm not talking 80% of single men. I'm talking about 80% of the single men who come to our churches who confess to be Christians. They are sexually active. 80%. That is a lot of guys. You know, there's like stat that was 57% of Christian men have either had an affair or been very tempted to have an affair. So this isn't just a cultural thing, it's affecting the men inside the church. And that's why we're going to offer this workshop, just talk and give some tips and some hints of how we can break these cycles and ways that we can start becoming the pure, holy men that God called every one of us to be.